Welcome to the Parenting Power Podcast, supporting parents with the real-life tools they need to raise the confident, interdependent people the world needs. Gail Bell and Julie Friedman-Smith interview experts who share their knowledge to assist parents in creating a home environment where kids can thrive.
Welcome to another Tool for the Trade. I'm Julie Friedman-Smith.
And I'm Gail Bell.
Today we are talking about family screen use with our third annual No Phone Family Day coming up. There's been so much information in the press right now about the effect of media on our family, the research that is coming out around parents' phone use, around children's phone use. There's so much information, it can feel overwhelming. So we wanted to take this Tools for the Trade to bring it down to the nitty-gritty, some key things that you need to know about your family and screen.
So the American Academy of Pediatrics has done a great job in helping parents, as well as the Canadian Academy of Pediatrics, outlining what we need to be looking at and recognizing as a family. Their guidelines for children younger than 18 months is to avoid screen use altogether, other than video chatting with a relative. They're suggesting that because of what we know about brain development now. Children ages 2 to 5, they're saying limit screen time to 1 hour a day of high quality program, but parents really should be co-viewing that media with their children to help them understand what they're seeing and apply it to the world around them. Cognitively, their brain development isn't there to do that on their own. So co-viewing high quality programs with them if they're going to be in front of a screen from 2 to 5 years. Regarding older children, I really like the way the Academy has said, stay away from you can only watch it this many minutes and just focus on limits, contents, and communication. So what they're saying about that is, yes, we still need to have consistent limits on the time spent and the types of media, but we want to make sure that it is available to them because technology is an incredibly useful tool. We do, as parents, need to make sure that it is not affecting their sleep, their physical activities, or other behaviors essential to health. And the one of the other behaviors that's really important that we know from the research now is their ability to calm themselves down. So when kids are emotional, and sometimes we feel like we want to hand them our phone or a screen to calm them down, we're not allowing them to learn a developmentally appropriate behavior that they, in fact, are able to calm themselves down without an exterior thing. And then the other thing that we know parents need to do is to designate media-free times together. Julie and I like to call it meals and wheels. So start small, set yourself up for success. So when you're eating and when you're driving, those are great times. And then if you can have other media-free locations in your home, the obvious one is bedrooms. Awesome. Finally, we want to have that ongoing communication about online citizenship and safety. And that's just about treating others with respect online and offline, including yourself, okay? So that communication absolutely needs to happen in the home.
Gail and I have created a couple of documents which you can download for free from our nophonefamilyday.com website in the resources section. There is a parent-child screen agreement worksheet. You can go through and see which of the statements apply to your family and initial the ones that do, cross out the ones that don't, make it really work for your family, do it with your kids. And you may need to do a different one for each of the kids in your family. And then the other document that we have there is some ways for parents to intentionally limit and use their screens and to be teaching our kids about screen use through the behavior that we're modeling. So you can get those over at nophonefamilyday.com. This has been another Tool for the Trade. To learn more about Parenting Power, check out our website, parentingpower.ca. Visit our Facebook page, or follow us on Instagram and Twitter at Parenting Power.